द थिंग विच आई हैड टीच यू इन द लास्ट क्लास वॉज वॉट इज डोमिनेंट ट्रेड एंड वॉट इज रेसेसिव ट्रेड. दोज हु हैड नॉट जॉइन द क्लास आई एम जस्ट giving it a quick revision that what I had taught you in the previous class. See, all the characters according to genetics, all the characters are transfer by with the help of your DNA, okay, your genetic material. And genetic material is found on your chromosomes, like your whole chromosomes is made up of DNA. So there are two characters which are found, okay. One character have two traits. For example, if I am talking about the characters of hair, see, I am having hair and I am comparing the hair, my hair with any one of you. So there is a character of hair and there are two different traits. One is short and one is long. Okay. So character is one, but the traits are two different. So the trait which is very common will found in the most of the population, that will be known as the dominant trait. Understood? And the trait which is very less found, that will be known as the recessive trait. For example, if in 100 of population of girls, 80 girls are having short hairs and only 20 girls will be having long hairs, then the short hairs will be of dominant trait. Understood? And the short and the long hair will be of recessive trait. It is just an example to make you understand that what is dominant and what is recessive. Okay, so here I am talking about the length, okay, long and short. So the alphabet which we will use to represent long and short will be capital L for long and small l for short, not S for short. Because I had told to all of you that character which we choose, okay, the dominant character which we choose, the capital letter of the capital starting letter of that character use as a dominant allele and the small letter of that alphabet used as a recessive allele. Understood? Ab allele kya hai? What is allele? Allele is a alphabetical representation, okay. For example, here I am going to show you like how you will represent L. See, I'm just, for example, here I am taking two seeds because further we have to study seeds. See, this seed is round, this seed wrinkled. Wrinkled means not round. Okay, this is round, this is wrinkled. The spelling of round is R-O-U-N-D and the wrinkled is W-R-I-N-K-L-E-D. Okay, but the things which we use to represent both of them is capital R for round and small r for wrinkled. Because capital R round is dominant character and small r is a recessive character. So the small letter of dominant character is used for recessive character and the capital letter of dominant character is used as dominant allele. Understood? Allele, all of you understood? What is allele? It is representation of alphabets. Okay? The alphabet which we use for the representation of traits. Okay. So this thing I had told you in the previous class. Now what we are going to study today is very interesting. Okay, I had also told to all of you what is sex determination. Now if you are listening to me very carefully, take a rough copy and write down what I am saying. Okay, write down or make a flow chart what I am saying. See, I had told to all of you that male have X and Y chromosome as their sex chromosomes. Understood? And female have XX chromosome as their sex chromosomes. So make a circle and write down XY as a male and XX as a female. Like given on page number, is it given? Yes. See, on page number 25, don't write it, just understand from page number 25. See, on page number 25, there is a female cell having XX and a male cell having XY. So when the fusion happens, what happens? One X of female fuses with one Y of male and forms a boy, because XY forms a male. But when X of female get fuses of X of male, it will form a female. Okay, because XX forms a female. Understood? ये चीज़ समझ में आ रही है? XX will form female, XY will form male. Okay, so male is having X and Y and female is having X and X. So when X and Y will fuse together, they will form male, and when X and X fuse together, they will form female child. Okay, so what will be the possibility? There will be the possibility of four child in which two will be boy and two will be girl. Okay, how it is possible? Because at one time one X will fuse with one X, then the another X will fuse with one X of male, then one X of female will fuse with one Y of male, and then the another X will fuse with the Y of male. So there will be the possibility of four child, two boy and two female. Okay, at a one time. See, if I am talking about the probability of having a baby girl or baby boy, what will be the ratio? 2:2, that is 1:1, that is 50% of the chances will be whether the baby will be male or whether the baby will be the female. Okay, most of the time. So this thing I had already taught you in the previous class. From now, what we have to study is the sex linked inheritance. Now please carefully see in the book at page number 29. So what will happen? See, case number 1. I will explain all the topic, like the full topic, sex linked inheritance, with the help of these cases. Because if you understand these cases, you will understand what is sex linked inheritance disease. These are the diseases which is related to the sex of the male and female parent, okay, and that is transferred by their sex chromosomes. Okay, so see, in case number 1, all of you see in the book, in case number 1 there is a normal mother, because on mother there is no any type of carrier of any disease, but the father is a color blind. And how you can identify the father is a color blind? Because see, on the X there is a knot like structure. The knot like structure indicate that father is a color blind. So when the cross will happen between mother and father, what will happen? The XX of mother and father, when gets combined, it will form XX daughter, and the daughter, in daughter both are having X chromosomes. So if both the chromosomes are X and only one X the carrier is there, the daughter will be not color blind, it will only having the carrier of that gene. Understood? She will be only the carrier of color blind, because both are having, both the
carrier means
the chromosome will contain that disease, but she will not be color blind. Understood? Means she got the gene from the father, but she will not be color blind, because both the chromosomes are X. So one X will compress the another X character. Okay, but what will happen to the boys? See, the father, only the Y chromosome of father will get fused with the mother X. Okay, in the case of boy. So what will happen in the case of boy? Both the boy will be normal, because Y is not having the carrier gene of disease. Understood? Language problem hai, language change kar le. Mother mein dono chromosomes XX the, father mein X aur Y the. Carrier kis pe hai? X pe hai. तो अगर एक्स एक्स का फ्यूजन होगा और एक एक्स पे सिर्फ कैरियर है, तो गर्ल सिर्फ उसकी डिजीज की कैरियर होगी, उसको वो डिजीज नहीं होगा फादर की तरह। लेकिन फादर का सिर्फ वाई ही जाता है जब बेबी बॉय फॉर्म होगा, ठीक है, क्योंकि बस वाई ही जाएगा, क्योंकि फादर के पास ही वाई है, मदर के पास तो वाई है नहीं। तो व्हाट विल हैपन, द सन, बोथ द सन विल बी नॉर्मल एंड बोथ द गर्ल विल नॉट गेटिंग अफेक्टेड, बट देयर द जीन विल बी कैरी बाय देयर क्रोमोसोम्स। अंडरस्टूड, ये चीज समझ में आई? नाउ सी द सेकेंड केस, व्हाट विल हैपन इफ द मदर इज कैरियर, इफ द मदर इज कैरियर, इट इज नॉट अफेक्टेड, ओनली कैरियर, देन व्हाट विल हैपन, सी इन रिजल्ट द चाइल्ड, द बेबी चाइल्ड विच इज यू कैन से द मेल चाइल्ड, द बॉय चाइल्ड विल बी गेटिंग अफेक्टेड, बिकॉज वेन द एक्स इज गेटिंग ट्रांसफर द एक्स नॉट रिप्रेजेंट दैट द सन इज कलर ब्लाइंड। अंडरस्टूड? ओके, एंड वन सन विल बी नॉर्मल बिकॉज द सिंपल द एक्स विच इज नॉट कंटेनिंग नॉट वेन फ्यूजेज विथ वाई it will form a one normal sun, and when it is fuses with the normal y and the carrier x, it will form color blind sun. Understood? See, it will take time to understand, you have to practice it. If both the chromosomes are same and on one chromosomes there is one knot, then it will only be the carrier of the disease, but both the chromosomes are different,
means usse kisi ko ho sakta hai lekin usse nahi,
usse nahi hoga, yes, usse kisi ko nahi hoga, uske hi offspring mein se kisi ko hone ke chances hain, sabko nahi hoga, offspring ko hone ke chances hain, usme bhi sare offspring ko nahi hoga, okay? carrier ka matlab kya hota hai, jo kisi cheez ko carry karta hai, और कोई चीज़ को कोई कैरी करता है, दैट डजंट मीन्स कि उससे उसको खुद को नुकसान होगा, बट वो किसी को नुकसान पहुंचा सकता है। ओके, अंडरस्टूड?
यस मैम।
ओके, सो दिस इज सेक्स लिंक्ड इनहेरिटेड डिजीज, मतलब ऐसी डिजीज़ जो कि सेक्सुअल क्रोमोसोम जो होते हैं वो कैरी करते हैं, और उनमें जब क्रॉस होता है तो ये ऑफस्प्रिंग में कैसे ट्रांसफ़र होते हैं, ये मुझे भी पता है, आपके बात आपके लिए फर्स्ट टाइम है, थोड़ी सी प्रॉब्लम हो सकती है, बट इसको एक दो बार आप पढ़ोगे, प्रैक्टिस करोगे तो हो जाएगा। कैसे कि दो फीमेल के पास दो एक्स है, मेल के पास एक एक्स और वाई है, एक एक्स एक बार मेल के एक्स और वाई से फ्यूज़ करेगा, फिर दूसरा एक्स भी मेल के एक्स और वाई से फ्यूज़ करेगा, तो टोटल पॉसिबिलिटी कितनी हो गई, चार हो गई, एक से दो, फिर एक से दो, दो दो चार, टू टू फोर, ओके, पॉसिबिलिटीज आर फोर ऑफ फोर चिल्ड्रेन, और कैसे फ्यूज करेगा वो भी इसमें मेंशन, ओके। नाउ नाउ सी पेज नंबर 30, मेंडल्स एक्सपेरिमेंट ऑन इनहेरिटेंस। सी स्टूडेंट्स, इफ वी एक्सपेरिमेंट समथिंग ऑन एनिमल और ह्यूमन, दैट इज इम्पॉसिबल, ओके, बिकॉज फर्स्ट थिंग द लाइफ स्पैन ऑफ ह्यूमन इज वेरी लाइक टाइम टेकन, इट विल टेक वन ईयर टू बिकम अ स्मॉल बेबी इन टू सम वॉट लार्ज बेबी, और इट विल टेक सेवरल ऑफ ईयर टू बिकम एन अडल्ट मैन, ओके, सो नो एक्सपेरिमेंट विल बी डन ऑन ह्यूमन एंड इट इज इलीगल ऑल्सो। सो मोस्ट ऑफ द एक्सपेरिमेंट और मैनी एक्सपेरिमेंट इज डन ऑन प्लांट एज वेल एज स्मॉल एनिमल्स टू गेट द रिजल्ट। सो द फादर ऑफ जेनेटिक्स वॉज ग्रेगर जॉन मेंडल। वाई ही वॉज नोन एज फादर ऑफ जेनेटिक्स, बिकॉज हिज सक्सेसफुल एक्सपेरिमेंट वॉज डन ऑन द प्लांट पी, ओके, फ्रॉम विच प्लांट ही हैड गॉट द सक्सेसफुल एक्सपेरिमेंट, फ्रॉम द पी प्लांट, the pea plant which you use at your in your vegetables, you know now what is pea?
Yes ma'am.
Okay, so the green leafy like structure, I'm talking about the whole green leafy like structure, okay, that plant was used by the Mendel to understand this experiment, okay, of genetics.
Ma'am, but plants, animals or humans to different hote hain na, unke andar
ka, no beta, but see what here you are not talking about the anatomy, you are not talking about the the morphology. What you are talking about? You are talking about the chromosomes, right? So chromosomes are found in animals, chromosomes are found in plant. So here the phenomena of crossing between the chromosomes are same in plants and animal as well as in unicellular organisms. Understood? So here what you have to study, not the anatomy, not the morphology, only the crossing of chromosomes. Okay? That's why the experiment was done. By the way, very good question. Who had asked this question?
Madhishri Shivastav.
Okay, very good, beta. Very nice question. So the Mendel has selected pea plant. So the very first question, why he had selected only pea plant? There is lots of plant on which he can conduct the experiment. This is because the pea plant was the only plant where he found 7 different characters. See, I had told you now what is the difference between characters and trait. 7 different characters, those who are having their different traits. Okay, they are contrasting traits. Now listen with the example. See, if I am taking the character of my hair, so there will be 2 traits, short and long. One hair will be short, one hair will be long. Okay, if I am taking the character of my face, there will be 2 possibility, round and oval. Okay, so round and oval both are 2 different traits. Okay, if I am taking my height, there will be the 2 different traits, short and tall. Understood? What is the difference between characters and trait? So he had taken pea plant because in pea plant there was 7 character and all the 7 characters was having 2 different traits. Now you understood what is character and what is trait? So Gregor John Mendel has selected pea plant to conduct his experiment because on pea plant there was 7 character and all the 7 characters having 2 different traits, and also it is a annual growing plant. Okay, and when he cropped the pea plant, he found that there are 7 characters and the 7 characters having the different traits. And what are those characters? See, on page number 30 it is given. The character were, first character was flower color. In flower color, what he had found, 2 different traits. The dominant was purple and the white was recessive. Dominant was purple and white was recessive. What does you means? Nikki, can you tell me what does it means? The purple flower was dominant and the white flower is recessive. What does it means?
Means
the maximum flower were purple and very less flower were white. That's why the purple is dominant and the white is recessive. Then he had found seed color. So the yellow was dominant and the green was recessive. Means maximum of the seed were yellow and the very less were the green. Then he had taken seed shape, and when he had taken seed shape, that in that the round is dominant and the wrinkled is recessive. Then he had taken pod color. Pod color means the cover in which seeds are embedded. The green is dominant and the yellow is recessive. Then the pod shape, the shape of the pod. If it is very flat, that is known as inflatent. And if it is round like as the structure of seed, that is known as constricted. So the inflated is dominant and the constricted is recessive. Axial, the flower, then the sixth one is flower position. Flower position means where the flower is situated on the plant. Axial or terminal. Axial means at the side, terminal at the top. Okay. Plant height, if when he had seen the the size of the plant, the tall was the dominant and the short was the recessive. Means maximum tall, maximum plant were tall and very less were the shorter one. Okay, now all of you understand what is character and what is trait. And now you understood why he had taken pea plant, because in a garden of pea he had saw seven characters, and seven characters were having two different traits. So now he started his experiment by crossing one character with their two different traits. So what he had done, that he take one tall plant and one short plant and cross between them. Okay, cross between them. And what he found, that in the very first generation all the plants were tall. Okay, all the plants were tall. How it is possible? See whether it is given or not. See at page number 31, the very first box which is given in the page number 31, see the yellow box. See the yellow box. See when he had fuses a pure tall with a pure dwarf, means capital T with small t, what he had found is capital T small t, means the combination of allele in such a way that in one pair one T was capital and one T was small. So what will be the result if one T was capital and one T was small? Because of the presence of one capital T, the result will be dominant. Understood? Agar dekho, alleles hamesha pair mein rehte hain. Alleles hamesha kaise rehte hain? Pairs mein rehte hain. Agar koi bhi allele agar dominant, agar un dono mein se koi bhi allele agar dominant hai, to uska result kya aayega? Dominant aayega. Kyun? Kyunki dominant wala allele रेसेसिव वाले एलील को सप्रेस कर देगा. अंडरस्टूड?
यस मैम.
ओके, नाउ ही हैड टेकन वन हेटरोजाइगस कंडीशन डोमिनेंट एलील. नाउ व्हाट इज हेटरोजाइगस? इफ वन एलील इज कैपिटल एंड वन एलील स्मॉल इन द पेयर, दैट इज नोन एज हेटरोजाइगस. And if both the allele, whether it is both are small and whether they both are capital, they comes into the category of homozygous. Both are same means homozygous, both are different, that means heterozygous. So in first generation what he had done, in the first generation, in the parent generation what he had done, he had taken a pure tall and a pure dwarf and crossed between them. So the first generation what he had found is that all were dominant, but in a heterozygous condition. Heterozygous condition means there was one capital T and one small t. Okay, then what he had done, he had taken that heterozygous alleles and fused between them. Means one capital T small t and one capital T small t. Matlab usne wo do plants liye jisme jo gametes ka jo alleles the wo heterozygous condition mein the aur unko fuse karaya. And when he fused both the plant, what he found, that one was pure T, one was pure tall, two was in heterozygous tall condition and one was pure dwarf. Understood? So if I will ask what will be the ratio of in F2 generation of tall and short, what you will answer? In F2 generation what is the ratio of tall and short? What will be the answer?
1:2:1.
No beta, that is the genotypic ratio na, means genes mein wo ratio na, ki ek pure hai, do impure hai, ek pure hai. I am talking about only tall and short, it will be 3:1, kyunki teen lambe honge ek chota hoga. 3:1. See here it is written also, genotypic ratio 1:2:1 hai, matlab genes ka ratio hai aisa. लेकिन देखने में फिनोटिपिक, मतलब देखने में जीनोटिपिक, मतलब जीन्स का. सो फिनोटिपिक रेशियो विल बी 3:1. अंडरस्टूड? अब जब पेज, व्हेन यू टर्न योर पेज, देर इज थ्री लॉ गिवन बाय द मेंडल, लॉ ऑफ डोमिनेंस, लॉ ऑफ सेग्रीगेशन. both the law you can understand with this example. In law of dominance, you can give the example when you are crossing one pure with one recessive, all the result which you found is dominant. Okay? When you cross one pure dominant and one pure recessive, all the result are dominant. This will show the law of dominance. Okay? In law of segregation, you can give the example when you take two heterozygous condition, when you fuse in between them, what you will see that there is the possibility of tall as well as short also, okay? As well as short also. And what will be the ratio? The ratio will be 3:1, okay? Now, the third law is very difficult, but you have to understand. What will happen to understand the third law? See, I am explaining overall things, not one by one. I am just explaining overall thing because with this you are able to understand what is the law all about. In law of independent assortment, he had taken two characters. Means in dominance and segregation, we are only talking about one character, that is height of the plant, tall and short, two different traits. But in law of independent assortment, he had taken two characters. One was the shape of seed and one was color of seed. So one seed he has taken fully dominant, means it was round also and it was yellow also. Okay, it was round also and it was yellow also, means he had taken two characters, but one seed has both the dominant trait, round also and yellow also. And another seed which he had taken was wrinkled and yellow, because wrinkled is also a dominant trait, sorry, recessive trait, and yellow is also a recessive trait. And when he fused between them, see, listen it very carefully. Wait. See, he had taken one round and yellow, means both the are dominant, and fuses with recessive, means wrinkled, and for green it is small y, because green is a what? Recessive trait. So I had told you for green you are not going to use G, you have to use small letter of dominant character. Okay, so in this law, what you will find that you had taken round yellow, a pure dominant, and you had taken wrinkled green, but the result which you will found will be round yellow, round green, then wrinkled yellow, and also wrinkled green. Understood? Means all the characters will be independently fuses with the other character. Means, see, you had taken only two seed, round yellow and wrinkled green, but in result what you are seeing, round yellow is also there, round green is also there, then wrinkled yellow is also there, and wrinkled green is also there. Had you got my point, students?
Yes,
samajh mein aaya? देखो रिंकल्ड येलो उसने एक राउंड येलो लिया था और एक रिंकल्ड ग्रीन सीड लिया था, बट रिजल्ट में उसको राउंड येलो तो मिला ही, रिंकल्ड ग्रीन भी मिला, साथ ही साथ इन दोनों का फ्यूजन भी मिला, मतलब डोमिनेंट के साथ एक प्योर रेसेसिव का कैरेक्टर भी शो हुआ. क्यों वो शो हो गया? क्योंकि अभी तक तो मैंने ये बताया था कि अगर डोमिनेंट है तो सिर्फ डोमिनेंट ही शो करेगा, क्योंकि वो दूसरा कैरेक्टर था. ओके, वो दूसरे कैरेक्टर का ट्रेड था. ओके, तो अगर दूसरे कैरेक्टर का ट्रेड अगर रेसेसिव है और दोनों एलील रेसेसिव है, तो वो डोमिनेंट के कैरेक्टर के साथ शो हो सकता है. अंडरस्टूड द पॉइंट? सो ये उन्होंने लॉ बताया था, लॉ ऑफ इंडिपेंडेंट अशॉर्टमेंट. इंडिपेंडेंट अशॉर्टमेंट का मतलब ही हो गया कि इंडिपेंडेंटली वो अशॉर्ट कर सकता है. तीनों लॉ में बस यही चीज़ है, इसी को थोड़ा ये बढ़ा चढ़ा के बोल दिया है. ठीक है, लास्ट टॉपिक जो इस चैप्टर का है, दैट इज म्यूटेशन. नाउ व्हाट इज म्यूटेशन? म्यूटेशन इज नथिंग, द डेफिनेशन इज सफिशियंट. म्यूटेशन इज अ सडन चेंज इन वन और मोर जीन. व्हेन इन अ जीन देयर इज अ सडन चेंज टेक प्लेस, फॉर एग्जांपल वन जीन इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर अ एक्स फंक्शन, okay, one gene is responsible for a function which is known as X, okay, and rather than X, he started doing X plus 1, that is a change. This type of change is known as mutation, okay. So mutation is a sudden change in one or more gene or in the number of the structure of chromosomes. And why this function is changed? Because there is a number, there is a change in number or structure of chromosomes. Understood? That is known as mutation. There are some diseases also available, students, which is a result of mutation. For example, sickle cell anemia and radioactive radiation. These both diseases are the example of mutation. Understood? Okay, so any one of having any doubt, or should I leave the class? And yes, please make your copy complete. Yes, Nirudh Yadav. Yes, beta. Okay, so I had just recorded a class. If anyone is having any doubt, please watch this video once again. I'm just uploading it on YouTube. Okay, and then make your chapter complete, and in our next class, I think most probably it will happen after the summer vacation, we will start our fourth chapter, okay, absorption by root. Okay, should I leave the class? Or see students, I am just saying once again, genetics is very easy. It's like you can say in maths you had learned the table. Firstly, when you were seeing the table, you were like, oh my god, so tough table it is. But when you practice the table, you can just count it. Oh, 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 4, 2, 3, 6. Genetics is such like that. Okay. So you have to just practice it. Okay. For 2 or 3 times, I guess you will watch 2 or 3 times my video.